Hallelujah, Pastor. Pray with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid if you just want prayer today. Hallelujah. Just want strength today. Hallelujah. You may be sick in your body. You want God to heal you today. Just come to the altar. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. You get ready to turn in his hands about the pastor. Hallelujah, the time. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. Pastor, you come at this time. Amen. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Amen.
Everybody got hands. I want you to stretch it toward the young lady with the white sweater on. God wants you to know he got your back. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Don't you be concerned about what people say. Because God wants you to know he's getting ready to break you out. Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, every situation, every problem, right now, in the name of Jesus, I expect for you to break her out. I expect for you to turn some things around. I expect for you to do it quickly. In the name of Jesus, give peace in the mind, peace in the midst of the situation. I don't care what the enemy said. I don't care what the enemy is planning on doing. I know one thing, God, that you are able. Turn things around. You are able to do it right now. In the name of Jesus. And I thank you for it, because you're going to do it, starting working on that case right now. You're going to start turning some things around right now. You're going to start fixing some things right now. In the name of Jesus. Give her peace in the midst of her storm. Give her joy in the midst of her storm. Let her smile when she should be crying. Let her laugh, God, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you. I thank you. Oh, somebody tell them thank you. I thank you. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. We serve and thank God for you today. I ask everyone to be here next Sunday. Well, you might miss something if you don't be here on next Sunday. I got something I got to announce on next Sunday. I'm trying to wait till everybody is here next Sunday. So it's very important that you be here. If you're not here, call and ask somebody, what did he say? It's very important. It's very important. Amen. God is getting ready to do something for this ministry. The best hidden secret in Memphis. And we thank God for you all on today. Just be encouraged. If you ever want to make the devil mad and he's trying to make you depressed, just smile. Because when your enemy see you looking sad and depressed, the enemy think, I got her. You just keep on smiling. I know it hurts sometimes, but keep on smiling. It's hard to smile when you're in the utility building. Study coming in the mail, and this bill, and you turn around, somebody else calling you about another bill, and you're trying to look and recognize that number so you won't talk to the bill collector. I've been there. Amen. But if you smile and just say, Lord, I'm trying to do the best I can, I'm putting this in your hand, and God, give me a peace of mind. Because you're not the only somebody that's going through. Certainly, we thank God for you. We thank God for our visitors. Would you like to have anything to say? You want to save it for next Sunday? Okay, she got a lot to tell us next. Make sure you come now. Now I want to hear what she got to say. We certainly thank God for you. You want to say anything?
Oh, no, I can stand here. My sister had her booking for next Sunday. She said my mom is in the hospital. And I didn't expect for her to come home until maybe next week sometime. But that girl, she'll cry, I promise. like she was doing her praise. They want me to come get her right now.
Things for you that you don't even know about.
Yes.
Go ahead, Uncle. Did you? Amen. We thank God for you. You know, if we praise God next Sunday, and not just in church, but in your car and in your home, God might test these folks where they make a mistake and accidentally send you a check from Social Security office. And might not realize they made a mistake from 50 years from now. By then, y'all be in a nursing home and ain't nothing they can do. So we don't know what praising God might do. Somebody in here could use $50,000 or $100,000. Somebody I know in here could use that besides me. What I'm trying to say to you, praising God would do open up some doors for you. We don't say praise God, just be praising God. We know something good is going to happen. So y'all be encouraged. It's very important that you make it on next Sunday. I'm asking that you, what's your name?
Shayla Oliver.
Shayla Oliver. Would you be my guest next Sunday? You'll be here? My guest? Amen. Thank God for you. Now listen, I wish some of y'all would. I'm going to ask everybody in here to ask 10 people. If you ask 10, now remember, if you ask 10, probably 8 going to say, I'm coming. That means 2 or 3 people. But ask 10 people. You got to do like they do at the club on Brooks. When I ride through there, somebody to line me just.
Oh, I know what it's talking about.
Just waiting to get in there because somebody told them what a good time they had.
That's right.
I'm just serious. They didn't tell them, though, that they had a hangover after that drunk that man. They left them out. They didn't tell them someone was just vomiting up and stuff. They left them out. So we all tell 10 people to get excited about what church is going, somebody can come.
That's right.
You got to get excited. That's how a salesman can sell y'all these lemons every year. Because they make it seem like it's exciting. It's a good running car. And y'all go, is it really? It's a good running car. What do CD sound like? What do radio sound like? You got to be excited in order for somebody to follow you. Ain't nobody gonna follow you and say, yeah, come on, church with me, guys. I'm going around with them. Just come on with me. You got to be excited and say, girl, I walked in there to press and I felt good when I left that place. I seen somebody was healed. I seen somebody got saved. I seen God do some awesome things in there. And believe it or not, you ask 10 people, you might get 3 or 4 to come with you. 3 or 4, because 6 of them just gonna tell you what you want to hear. But you might get 3 or 4 to come. So Danielle, I expect you to bring at least 3, not the same old folks out there. Bring a different thing, and you'll come in here with the same folks. I want to see somebody different. I ain't worried about you. You can talk. So I expect you to come. Yeah, I expect her to pray for her. I ain't worried about her. Is your mom still living? Why don't you ask if you can be our guest next week?
I'm gonna ask her, but they be having, she be doing so much.
Yeah.
You know.
But make her seem excited.
I make her seem excited because I'm just not like her. She excited. I make everybody excited. Yeah.
Man, we thank God. She's always full of energy.
Yeah, I can't be. It's not
come on, Mr. Ryan.
I'm too black to be stressed. For real.
Oh, that's right.
Amen. Grab somebody by the hand. Amen. Amen. Hear me, Father. We thank you.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for your spirit, God. And we thank you, God, for your miracle of this morning, God.
Yes, Lord.
The young lady mother, God, we just thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
God, we thank you. Continue to heal the body, God. In the name of Jesus, God. God, we just thank you. We give you the glory, God. And God, we lead this place, God. You bring us back into your party hour.
Thank you, Jesus.
We ask in your son, Jesus' name. And everybody in the house say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See yourself dismissed.
Right.